So I wanted to talk about a movie that I was watching yesterday, but then I decided instead of just talking about it, I could do part of it for you. But in order to do it, I need some costume. So I'm going to turn the mic on. Put on my costume. Isn't this lovely? Don't we usually wear one of these, so it's a little tricky. And the rest of my costume. Isn't this lovely? I'm gorgeous. Fabulous. Now I need to cue my music. So I was watching this movie and it made me think about what happens to Jesus. And so I want to share that with you if I can get my phone to work. Wasn't that beautiful? My wife would be so proud. Not of what I just did, but that I didn't lose my cell phone for a whole, like, half an hour so I could use it. Do you know what movie that's from? Frozen, right? And I was thinking of the littler kids who are here who would know that reference and they would enjoy it, but you maybe enjoy it too. In that movie, Elsa, the girl who is at the focus of it, has to let go of some things, right? Let it go, let it go. Do you remember what she needs to let go of? Remember when I was doing this? The perfect girl is gone, right? She had to quit. She had problems in her life, and people told her, just hide them and pretend they're not there so that people think that you're the perfect one. So the first thing she had to do was learn to let that go. Learn to let go her desire to hide everything that she didn't think she should show to other people. And then later, she learns that she needs to let go of her tendency to be away from people and let go of her fears and figure out who she was meant to be. And she does that because her sister shows her what love is like. And once she experiences that love, she's able to become something new. Today, we're going to be talking about how it's just a part of our life that there are times where we have to let one thing go and let new things happen. She had to let go of her hiding things and be who she was. She had to let go of her fear and hold on to love. And later on in the service, we're going to do a thing. I'm going to talk about it more in the sermon if you're here. But where people are going to, after they receive communion and are reminded that God loves them, they're going to come here, and I have a whole bucket of stones. And what I'm going to ask you to do, and you to do, is to choose two stones. One of them is something that it's time to let go of. That can be whatever you think that might be. I'll talk about that a little bit in the sermon. You're just going to leave it here in the font with Jesus. The other thing is something new that it's time to take hold of. And maybe you already know what that is. You're like, oh no, do I have to think about this? But maybe it is. And that one you put in your pocket and you take with us, take with you as you go forward. All right, can you remember that when it comes that time? So after you get communion, you can just do that and we'll have a nice font filled with stones. Can you remember that long? Okay, good, let's say a prayer. Holy and gracious God, I thank you that you have made us who we are and that when you look at us, your first words to us are always, you are my beloved. With you I am so pleased. We pray that you might help us to remember that and help us in this hard work of figuring out what it's time to let go of and what the new thing we need to take hold of is. And we pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.